So, it's time to play some Nick Fit, right? Like, Legacy is fixed now, so we might as well play some Nick Fit. We're about to go into a league that is a comedy of errors. I am filming this intro after the gameplay, which I sometimes do. And I need to stop doing it, because I think you can tell how well the league is going to go by how upbeat and charming I'm being, or how miserable I'm being. So this is going to be an interesting one. There are lessons to be learned. This is Bug Nick Fit with a little splash of white for a single reliquary, Knight of the Reliquary. We're playing blue for Pyr and Toothy. I actually genuinely enjoy this combination of cards, and I think in a good version of this deck, this is a reasonable include. If you don't know, then we've got partner from Battle Bond. Pyr goes and grabs Toothy. Toothy goes and grabs Pyr on ETB. So that's the first part of this. The next part is if Pyr will basically, if you put a counter on an opponent you control, including Planeswalkers, you can play Planeswalkers alongside it, you up those counters. And if you draw a card, you put a counter on Toothy. So if Pyr and Toothy in play together, you put two counters on Toothy for every card drawn. And then when it dies, or leaves, should I say, if it's Caracas bounced or Exile with the Swords of Plowshares, you draw cards equal to the counters on it. So you can actually go Pyr, grab Toothy, play Toothy, grab Pyr, the other copy of Pyr, then grab the other Toothy. And you're getting card advantage each time you cast one of them and then resolve it. And then you can play the second Toothy into the first Toothy, which kills the first Toothy. Then you draw a lot of cards and grow the second Toothy. It's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. On top of that, we've got the typical Nick Fit stuff. We've got Veteran Explorer, which when it dies, you get to go basic lands out of our deck. And we've got Cabal Therapy to sack that off and attack our opponent's hands. And one copy of Double Intent to do that as well. So we're going to try to kill our vets and grab basics out of our deck. This is the core part of Nick Fit. The thing is with Nick Fit, the idea is that your opponent won't have many basics. This league will prove otherwise. But if you play against Delver, in theory, sometimes they don't have any basics. You grab basics, so you jump up two mana, and with that you play four drops and five drops. Now, we're only playing Shifting Ceratops, Toothy, and Elder Gargoth in this, like, 4 or 5 point mana pip sweet spot. We probably should be playing more, but that mana also allows you to play, like, utility stuff, like you have four copies of Greensense here to go get any of your Silver Bullets. Silver Bullets being Ramana, Excavator, Reclamation Sage, Tarlish Tracker, Knight of the Reliquary, Uro, and Leovold, and it also allows you to, like, Pernicious Deed things away as well. Pernicious Deed and Pyr and Toothy play well with Planeswalkers, so I feel like I probably should have played a Planeswalker variant today. But I thought I'd give a more mid-range creature-based toolbox version a go. And well, you're about to see how well that goes. If you like the video, hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe. I'm Pleasant Kenobi. If you're going to pick up any bits and bobs from channelfireball.com, use the code Kenobi at checkout to help support myself and my unique brand of failing miserably. If you want to see a successful Legacy League or two, I've had some go up on my channel recently. Hopefully you'll find some enjoyment and learning experiences from this. Oh, magic is a harsh mistress. You can check out my content over on youtube.com/PleasantKenobi and twitch.tv/PleasantKenobi. With that out of the way, well, I should mention the box break, shouldn't I? Yeah, you can pick up box breaks at channelfireball.com, so you can get part of a box. You basically get randomly allocated a color from that box, and when they crack the box, you get the cards from that, and it's all cracked on screen, on stream. It's an interesting way to, like, pick up new cards without picking up a whole sealed box. So, links to that in the description, I'd hope, if the editor hears this. I don't know! Right, let's play some Legacy. I'm not guaranteeing any wins, but let's play some Legacy. And we are off to the races, round one. I'm adjusting my pants for maximum comfort. And, well, this hand doesn't do a whole lot. It doesn't interact in any way. We don't have a Cabal Therapy. We don't have a Veteran Explorer to try and get ahead in some way. We just have a 3-drop, a 4-drop, and a 5-drop. I'm going to mulligan this. I'm going to keep this. We have Green Suns and a Vet. I'm going to put the Dryad Arbor back. And say, done. There we go. And we see a Flooded Strand from our opponent. Okay. So, we're going to draw for turn a Vet. I'm just going to slam a Vet here. Maybe we'll get Dazed. We've got a second Vet to follow up with. Obviously, we have no way to kill it right now. Hopefully they aren't a Plowshares deck. I have a feeling they're going to be, right? There we go. There we go. We can get plowed now. That's fine. We've got a second one coming up. So they're on some form of blue-white control, most likely. There might be a Stoneblade variant. There's the Mystic Sanctuary. Would love to draw. What would I even like to draw here? Brainstorm's not bad. We're going to play a Vet. Pass back to our opponent. Hope they don't have a second Plowshares. We can't exactly brainstorm for a Force of Will because we... Yeah, okay. What can you do? What can you do? They are Jeskai colors. They could still just be straight up miracles. They're going to cast a Gnar set. We're going to brainstorm now before that resolves. We're going to find a Horizon Canopy and an Elder Gargaroth. Put the Gargaroth on top. Put the Tarlis Tracker on top. Yeah, let's do that. They downtick. What do they find? We're in a pretty shocking position right now. After having both our vets exiled and then them finding a Force of War, which is now in their hand. Just going to play the Canopy. Going to play a Tracker. This will... Well, actually, I'm going to play a Tracker. No, I'm going to play a Knight. This will get forced, most likely. No, they're going to let that resolve. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. That means we can, like, Green Suns into a vet and grab a the Phyrexian Tower and sack it and yada, yada, yada. Problem being that the Green Suns will get forced. But having a Knight in play is good. They downtick Gnar set. If we were a Planeswalker heavier version of Nykfit, traditionally the Abzan versions that I have played a lot of Planeswalkers. I know John, one of my good friends and chief admin on my Discord, is obsessed with the idea of playing Planeswalkers alongside Pyr and Toothy. Time Raveler. Well, I guess our position just gets progressively worse and worse. So our next card we draw is not a land, we know that much. So we're going to fall behind on land drops as well. We can catch up, obviously, with Vets later down the line. They've got five cards in hand, including, of course, a Force of Will. We're just going to play Knight again. It resolves, which means we're probably going to get them untapped. They're probably going to play Big Teferi, or they're going to snap you and Plowshares. And then I kind of just want to give up at that point. This is my problem with playing against specifically this kind of deck in Legacy, or even Modern to a lesser extent, is that like you fall so far behind, but you know you've got like 3 hours, 3 hours to go. Yep, they're going to bounce the Knight. Yeah, we've got a concession coming up very soon. We're not going to be getting back into this game with a selection of Planeswalkers. I mean, these aren't doing a huge amount against us. We drew a Pyr. I guess I'll just cast it again, which is just embarrassing, really. I feel like I'm... You know in The Simpsons when Sideshow Bob is just stepping on rakes and they're hitting him in the face and hitting him in the face? I feel like every single one of our opponent's plays has been a rake to the face. Yep. This is super fun. I mean, I'm enjoying this. On the upside, Jace isn't brainstorming for them. It's not also ticking up towards the inevitability of an ultimate, although they will start to do that next turn. Mystic Sanctuary gets back Plowshares. Yeah, you know what? I've seen enough. Game's over. Game's over. Dreadful start from us. Absolutely dreadful start. We're going to go Velisimer and Thoughtseize into our deck. I'm tempted to bring in Flusterstorms, but they can't count the Planeswalkers, so we won't. Hymns we will bring in. We will... Deeds don't kill Walkers, right? Cut both Deeds. Bring in Brop Decay and Assassin's Trophy as well. Plague Engineer. We'll keep one in case we need to like dig for it with our Brainstorms and our Sylvan Libraries if they have our Monastery Mentor. We'll cut the Gargaroth. It's not great against Plowshares. Need to make three more cuts. Collector Oof feels a bit bad here. Scooze is okay against the Mystic Sanctuary Recursion. Diabolic Intent has additional costs. So we're not going to have that against Force of World decks. And I'll cut one Pyr. Okay, that's our game plan now. I would love to play first. This hand is reasonable. It's reasonable. We're going to keep it and go turn one Cabal Therapy, turn two Green Suns for a Vet Cabal Therapy. So we can tear their hand to pieces and accelerate ourselves. And then we just need to find a five or decent three mana threat. We've got cut our Elder Gargoth, so we don't have any five mana threats. I'm not playing Titania, which I kind of think I should be playing Titania, honestly. We're too toolboxy, I think. We need more top end. But Pyr and Toothy is our top end. That's, kinda. So is our opponent mulliganing? have a look. No, of course not. Of course not. Let's go, Misty. We're going to grab a Bayou or an Underground Sea. I think I'm going to grab an Underground Sea. Yeah, let's grab Underground Sea. It's therapy then. I guess I'm going to name Force of Will to try and make sure my Green Sun Zenith gets through. The other option, blind naming, is obviously cantrips that I might cast on turn one, but let's get rid of... Okay, they crush the weak. We just like have Wrath with Foretell, a Ponder and a Mentor. So we're going to see a Ponder out of them this turn, then we can Cabal Therapy the other Mentor away. The only Mentor away, should I say. Ponder from our opponent. If you hear some weird noise in the background, that's my puppy. Both my dogs, actually. They're in here at the moment while my wife's on a call. I decided to take the brunt of them. And they have, because of lockdown, they're very, very much attached to my wife because they're all sitting in her office. So now that they've got to be in my office for, 45 minutes to an hour, they're constantly just like sat near the door making the occasional noise as if it's the worst thing in the world to be near me. And I get it. I hate me too. Okay, so we drew the vet anyway. That's good. So we don't have to use our green sands for this. We can actually use it with the mana we're about to get. We're going to target them again, sacking the vet. Say okay. We're going to name Monastery Mentor. Say yes. We're going to grab a snow-covered forest and a swamp. Cool. And then this will hopefully resolve. If not, we can Veil if they have drawn a force or similar. They're going to brainstorm. Okay. Now, I could Veil now to give it uncounterable, but I'd rather they tried to counter it. They're going to put the Monastery Mentor back on top of their library, evidently. So that's it then. Them drawing a brainstorm with the Ponder is huge. But that said, with the Ponder, they were probably digging for the brainstorm to allow them to react to this. We're going to go with Crush the Weak then, I guess. Yeah, so we got rid of one card. They got a Ponder in hand. Monastery Mentors on top of their library. Two Tarns, two Mystic Sanctuaries, a Ponder. Crush the Weak is now gone too. I'm just going to play a Plague Engineer here. A name Human. This way we hit... Oh no, it's Monk, isn't it? We have to name. Because that way we hit the tokens. I would love to name Human to hit Snapcaster, but I don't think we can. I don't think we can. I know we can't. We need to do something to make that Mentor not too good. Now, they'll be able to deal with this Plague Engineer relatively sharpish, right? That's the problem. They play a Tarn. They're not going to play out the Mentor until it makes sense. They've got a Ponder and one other card, probably the Mentor, I'd imagine. We drew Shifting Ceratops, which we're just going to slam, I think. Yeah, this gives us a good attack, right? Give it haste. Then go to combat. They might have a Snappy here to block our Plague Engineer, I guess. No, it's the Mentor that's in hand, right? So we do 7 to them. Next time we can Grease Hands for a Pier and grab a Toothy. Or we can Grease Hands for Leovold. Terminus off the top. Okay. That Brainstorm not only protected them from our hand attack, but also found them the miracle. That's quite impressive. I'm not going to lie. They just play a Mentor and cast a Ponder, and they are miles ahead again. That Brainstorm plus Ponder did a lot of work for them. huge amounts of work. So much work that I feel like I'm... I feel like they're playing Legacy and I'm over here playing, like, Historic. Oh, that's funny. That is funny. So we can grab a Pyrrha, get a Toothy. We can get an Uro, which is just Garbo here. Tyler's Track if we draw a land, maybe, but that doesn't seem that good. Leovold would stop them drawing cards off their cantrips, but they're... Well, they got a Ponder there. So we know they've got a ton of lands in hand, including two Mystic Sanctuary, which means they can put Terminals on top of their library. God, this sucks. So I guess we want to eat stuff out of their bin. So maybe we have to get a Skooze. Maybe we have to get a Skooze. To cut off their graveyard options and get rid of it. Because otherwise, whatever we get just gets Terminused. Not really much we can do about that. Now, we keep up Veil of Summer in case they untap and like play Jace or Teferi. it's not the best, but it's something. Obviously, we're not protective against Plowshares. Plowshares just gets us. Okay, both Tarn's gone, the Ponder's gone. The Strand's gone. There's a Teferi. Grows their team. Teferi lands. They go for the bounce. Yeah, I'm going to give... Oh, no, Vince, you're meant to cast your response to the Teferi, Vince. Okay, it's fine. I have punted pretty hard there, but what can you do? That's huge. Huge. Should cast it on the stack. They would have just upticked the Teferi. I was so hellbent on the idea of getting them not to draw a card and us drawing a card that I just completely blanked on the static ability, which is dumb considering how oppressive it has been. Miracles has always probably been my least favorite deck in Legacy by a large margin, and it continues to be just that, my least favorite. Let's gonna go Cabal Therapy. Can't name Mystic Sanctuary. Ponder. No, there's two Ponders already used. Let's name Brainstorm. Force of Negation, Engineered Explosives. Okay. Play that. They can Force of Negate the backup therapy and then they have EE. I'm going to grab two green sources here. The Force Negate, we get the cantrip at least. We're going to grab snow-covered... Oh no, we already grabbed a forest. It's a snow-covered forest and a swamp. Sorry, not snow-covered forest, should I say. I think I should have played a Quart Rotation in this deck onto the Field of the Dead. They Force Negate that. We should have held priority, or maybe Veil before? Nah, maybe not. So we can't Veil here because of Teferi, that's fine. We now cantrip our Veil. Draw a Misty, play a Misty. Go Skooze. Crack the Misty. Grab another green source. Will it buy you? Yeah, let's do that. And then let's hope they can't bounce this so we can actually eat some vets, block some monks, and maybe, just maybe... Oh no, we just died at EE, don't we? all this, like, I'm literally like, it's the rake scenario again, right? I'm like, oh, maybe I'm okay. And I step on a rake. I'm like, no, no, no. That is not good. Yeah, okay. I'm going to scoop it up as we get to the next round. This went awfully. I think conventionally, we should have a composition where we can beat this kind of control deck. I think the build that I've got today, which is me mucking about, yeah, it can't. Like, just our basic creatures versus their planeswalkers just doesn't do anything, no matter how toolboxy we get. And then me punting also makes it worse too. So, that's that. Okay, we've won the die roll. Let's say yes. Let's keep this hand. It's pretty sweet. I am quite into it, as the kids would say. I'm not going to do a blind cabal. I don't want to really throw my veteran into a plowshares, but I'm going to anyway. We're going to go trop into vet. Let's go trop into vet. Because we've got green-black over here. So green into veteran. Pass the turn to our opponent. Would like to not see double plowshares from our opponent like last time. That would be lovely if they wouldn't just have the exact removal spell in the format that we don't want to see. Like, if you're up against Bolt and Push and back in the day, Disfigure or any of the other things that we've seen in Legacy through the years, you're gravy, right? They can't take out your 1-1. It just doesn't do anything. It's bad to do. Plowshares just makes you spin your wheels. Makes you step on a rake. Just badonk, straight into the face. So our opponent is taking their time on the first turn. Are they talking to us? No, they're not. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. The eighth card that they drew there must have completely transformed their game plan, I think. Because they weren't... On seeing their opening hand, they weren't sure what their opening line was. That eighth card really pushed them over. They were like... Well, choices, choices, choices. That said, it might be that they have a turn one kill and they're thinking it through. That'd be funny, wouldn't it, if I'm being all sarcastic over here and we just get shot to death by... a turn one storm kill. I really hope that isn't the case. That would be less than fun, I want to say. Chrome Mox. Okay. Now, if they Blood Moon here, but we ain't casting much for a while. So here comes the Blood Moon. Yeah. Should have fetched a basic forest, Vince. Should have fetched a basic forest. Now, if we can kill our vet or draw one of our quite a few basics, we're all good. We did not. We did not. No attacks in case they play a ramble. Guess we'll get screwed over again. It's my bad. Like, you know, you can play around these things, right? Right? I could have played around that. I could have got a basic forest. It wouldn't have done anything. Oh, I guess what I should have done was led with a Bayou into the vet. But then our fetch land would just be a mountain in hand, so we can't get us a basic. I could have gone and got a basic Swamp and Cabal Therapy turn one, but blind naming Blood Moon will only get you there, like, what? Let's say they're 5% of the metagame right now, maybe at 10 at most, as it's quite popular to play Chalice decks right now. And then the opening hands like Blood Moon again, you're only like a, what, 40 or 50% chance? Maybe 60, 70, if we count the fact that they probably mulligan to... Or only keep hands, should I say, that have a lock piece. But then again, that could be also Chalice of Trinisphere. So your chances are like sub 3% blind naming Cabal Therapy. Some of you might be thinking that seems high. Maybe it's lower than that. Maybe it's lower than that. So obviously I'm talking meta games and hands that they keep. And you're likely to have it in hand as well. But 3% is not high, obviously. If you're thinking that's high, then maybe you're high. Maybe you've been smoking. They're thinking long and hard again. How? I mean, I don't want to come across as salty, but how? And I play Red Prison. I love that deck. And I don't think it's the thoughtless, brain dead deck. But to be fair, maybe they're thinking about sequencing, right? You got this turn, next turn, even the turn after. All these things require sequencing. I don't think about things, and I lose a lot of magic. So maybe. Maybe I'm a fool. I guess they want to play in such a way that the Veteran Explorer never dies. And the problem they've got is Stomp, Giants, Rabble Masters, all this sort of stuff. They all kill it. Okay, so I'm going to get a block and get some lands and unlock our hand eventually. And this would be very good at killing humans or gobos. So we don't attack here. We just hold it back as blockers. Do we draw basic? No, we draw a mountain. That's fine. Main deck, we do have Pernicious Deed to blow up the Blood Moon and the Chrome Mox. If and when we get our vet killed, we're going to go and grab a blue source and a black source. That will strand Tyra's Tracker in hand, but it'll give us access to four spells. And I mean, well, actually, getting a... If I draw Pernicious Deed or another vet, I'm going to be quite sad that I didn't get a green source. But Brainstorm will help us get somewhere as well. And we can brainstorm. We want to brainstorm post Toothy, really, don't we? We can brainstorm and shuffle with the Toothy, is another thing. Just shuffle the tracker away or try and find ourselves a green source. Four mana. Is this a Fireflux squad? Oh, this is sick. I played a bit of this in Living the Dream Cube. So it's hacks now. We can exile the Hanawar Garrison and then they just get a creature from their deck. And it could be anything, but they aren't attacking, which makes a lot of sense. Can we draw a basic? We did draw a basic. Okay. I wonder what they've got in their deck. Do they have, like, Ulamog? Is that where the Fireflux squad is taking them? Ancient Tomb, okay. Fireflux squad is like a... It's like an actual playable Winota in Legacy. Winota is very good, don't get me wrong, but I don't think you can play it in your prison decks because you have to play like a critical mass of creatures, and the prison decks play like, what, 12 to 16 creatures total. It's also cool to see a lot of people playing different variants of the Blood Moon Red prison deck. So there's the Giants variant. I saw someone on stream on Monday playing 8 Rabble plus the Giant with Stomp. It's wicked. So they're going to attack... They're going to make 2/1s. The Fireflux Squad didn't attack because we can block it. We're going to block like this and like this. I think that's safe. If they pump their team, I'll be gutted. Vet dies. We get 2 clues out of this as well. So we're going to get a blue source and a black source. And we're loving life at this. Well, I say loving life. We're under quite a bit of pressure. But we're loving life as much as you can love life in this scenario. A blue and a black source. Get 2 clues. We're going to crack one of them on end step. We're going to crack a clue. This is the Chalice of the Void. What do we draw off the clue? Sylvan Library. We're going to brainstorm a response to the Chalice simply because we can't do so afterwards. We're going to put Cabal Therapy and Cabal Therapy back because of the Chalice. We're going to... The Chalice resolves. We're going to use Toothy to shuffle away one of those Cabal Therapies. The final card is Chalice on 2. Can't play the Sylvan Library now. Okay, that's fair. That's pretty solid. Pretty solid. Draw one of those Cabal Therapies. Play a Misty. Get a clue. Play a Tooth. No, don't tap your green, Vince. Blue, this, and this for Toothy. Trigger. We're going to choose target player ourselves. I forgot you can target other people because of the two-headed giant nature of Battle Bond. Grab a Pia. And then whilst I want to crack a clue to grow, I think I just want to kill every human they've got here and shrink all the other humans. So human. There we go. And they've got a 3-2 and a 1-2. We won't be attacking, that's for sure. Pia will allow Tyler's Tracker to grow very big very quickly. If we draw another Cabal Therapy here, I'm convinced that Modo is bugging out. I've seen this a lot when we're playing Living the Dream Cube, where you'd like scry something and then shuffle your deck and it'd just still be on top. I mean, obviously there is a chance for that. And of course there are 2 more Cabal Therapies in our deck, but it's just, it happens so... But then again, is it anecdotal and am I getting confirmation bias or whatever the term is that I'm seeing it and I'm not noticing what doesn't happen? I mean, the only time it's ever happened in paper, I remember very vividly, when my opponent had a Gyarados 8th grade on top of their library, it was going to wreck me playing D&T, I ghost caught them to make them shuffle. They shuffle even though they don't have to. They shuffle, I cut, they reveal, and there's a Gyarados 8th grade on top of their deck again. And I can't remember what was revealing it. What was revealing it? I can't remember. But either way, like, I remember that more than any other time where I have shuffled something away and it hasn't come back, right? So you do remember the circumstances where it screws you more. Definitely, definitely. I'm enjoying Legacy at the moment, though. I'm playing dumb stuff, cool stuff, fun stuff, and just enjoying it. Even losing matches with, like, Food Chain on Monday, it was still fun. And that's the important bit, right? If you can enjoy yourself whilst losing, yeah, that's the one. So we're going to draw a card that's turned, but a counter on Toothy. Play Pia, and then Toothy will grow by two counters Atomic Cracker Clue, as will Tyler's Tracker. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. If they kill Toothy now, is it power and toughness or is it counter? No, we would get no cards. But they've got Plague Engineer and Tireless Tracker to deal with, and they have only got one card in hand. I keep checking chat to see if they're saying stuff to us, but they're just tanking a little bit, and that's reasonable. That's reasonable. Maybe they'll attack and just exile the Hanamar Garrison to try and find a non-human threat. Is this just Big Chandra? Six mana Big Chandra. Shatter Skull. That's really good here. Okay. Was that their best draw other than six mana Chandra if they're playing it? Probably. They're going to hit us for like 1,000 damage. And we go from... I felt confident. And now I feel like Shatter Skull Summit... Or Shatter Skull Smashing, sorry. Shatter Skull Smashing. Doesn't sound quite like a magic card. Has just ruined everything. So we're screwed, I think, now. We are not in a good spot. What can we draw? Not a Cabal Therapy, I should imagine. That'd be nice if it didn't bug out. We're good. Okay. Scooze is pretty good. So we draw a card. Put a counter on Imaginative Friend. We can't play Scooze nor activate it that much right now. So I guess we play Imaginative Rascal. Target myself. Say okay. You'll grab our other Pia. We can't put the Scooze anyway because of the Chalice. That would have been embarrassing, wouldn't it? Draw a card, put two counters on Pia. Oh, on Toothy, sorry. Draw the Cabal. Okay, so that's not a bug. That's just unfortunate. That's just a little bit unlucky. Okay. We now have a 4-4 and a 1-1, and they have just a million mana coming at us. Like a million mana. A million damage. I would like them to draw another land. Flood a little bit, you know? We are flooding with cards we can't cast. Which, honestly, that's because our opponent has played... Like, choices our opponent has made. The Charleston 1, the Charleston 2 was strong. We have blue and black mana ups. They have to be fearful of that. There is an argument, I guess, at the beginning of the game that we just fetch a basic forest and play a Verdant Explorer to... To fetch land and a vet. To play around both Blood Moon and Wasteland. But if I'm honest, I don't think you play around Wasteland and Blood Moon when you've got vets available. I'm unsure, honestly. I'm a little bit unsure. So, do they attack? I assume they're going to attack and exile one of those human tokens. Get themselves something else brutal. Yeah, they do. Okay, so more 1-1s. Sure. Exile a 1-1. What do they get out of it? A Legion War Boss. Okay, we're going to crack a clue. Draw a Tireless Tracker. Make a 6-6 Toothy. Go to blocks. If we block here, we hit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and we survive. I think that's better than losing the pier right now, honestly. Like, we're very dead next turn. So we take the least amount of damage we can here with one block. Maybe blocking the 2-3 is better, but then 4-5, 6-7, 8, 9. Going to 1 is not good. Pernicious Deed would be lovely. Pernicious Deed is easily our best draw. We draw a card and put another 2 counters on Toothy. We drew Wasteland, which is terrible. Now, if we play our current Toothy, we actually draw 7 cards. So that might be what we have to do here. So we attack for 8, play a Toothy, draw a Deed. Deed for 0, kill 3 tokens, have a blocker, take 3. Deed for 0, play a Scavenging Ooze, take 1. I think this is where we're at. Take him to 12. Play another Pier. So now we draw 8 cards and put like a load of counters on our Toothy, and we have a huge threat. Grab the last Pier, so that's one less bad card we don't want to draw. Put tons of counters on here. Did we draw a Deed? We did not draw a Deed. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So Field of Dead gives them the blocker. And then we Green Suns for 2. And then we have a load of blockers. We have 4 blockers. And they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 attackers. And we're dead. Skews don't do much. I can Green Suns for 3. I guess we can also like Rexage the Blood Moon or the Chalice on 1. I guess I can gain 4 life off of Green Sunning for Knight of the Reliquary. If we play an untapped land, which will be the Wasteland. Gain 4, hope that's enough. Go to 7, they attack. We block, block, block. Take 3, 4, 5. Yeah, I think that's our only option here. Is to Green Suns for 3. Oh, we don't have a Knight. Oh, I'm an idiot. Knight of the Reliquary doesn't gain us life. I'm thinking of Knight of Autumn. That's bad. Okay. Vexage, kill a Chalice on 1. Play a Vet, block. And then we get 1, 2, 3. We block. Do, 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 do. Take 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't know if we have an out, honestly, because of that Chalice. The Chalice plays. Plague Engineers in our graveyard. Green Suns for Uro. Gain 3. Guess that's our best bet. And then hope that blocking the 2 big things. We go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. No, that doesn't do it either. Now we're the ones tanking. Kind of direct sage and cabal therapy and then like vet and la di da di da. All Green Suns for 3. This gets us an Uro at best. What else does it do? What else does it do? God, I'd love to get a Plague Engineer in our graveyard right now. That'd be lovely. Oh, the line. The line was green sun's for two, so it's a three mana spell. Get a vet by playing a land. Oh no, because we couldn't have fielded them. We need to cabal therapy in the bin. Should have cast one into the chalice early on when we had mana, so we could have sacked a vet to it. And then the vet gets us more lands, more. Yeah, okay, we're good. We're good. We're dead. We'll go Titan, get six. Take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Are we alive if we are? I don't think we are. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah. Oh, but we get to make a blocker off the field of the dead. We don't make a block off the field of the dead. 1, 2. Oh, because these are all just called mountain. Wait, no, they're not though, are they? 1, 2, 3. Oh, but the field of dead's a mountain. Hup, de derp. The field was never a line. Oh, that's funny. That's funny. So much thought going in, and there's so many things stopping me from doing anything that I want to do. We're going to cut, like, two brainstorms, bringing in Abrupt Decay and Assassin's Trophy. Him is reasonable, but it's also color intensive. I don't think that's a good idea. Let's submit that. Oh. Lots of problems. We'd have to have Rexaged the Blood Moon to get Field online. That would have given us four blockers. We would have blocked the two, the two, and the two. There would have still been five guys coming through. We're on three. If we're throwing Pyre under the bus, we would have drawn less cards. Oh, so many moving parts. That's kind of the reason I love Legacy, right? Because of this being so many moving parts. Yeah. Fun game, though. Fun game. I kind of don't want to get blown out turn one, two. That would be nice. With, like, double plowshares or Blood Moon. I'd like to have a bit more of a game early on. We're on the play now, so we can just blind name. Do you know what? I'm going to bring in Thoughtseize and cut a Brainstorm. We're now on one Brainstorm. Thoughtseize is obviously bad against the Charles deck, but we're on the play. We're on the play. I guess we got to tank a little bit more than our opponent did in that last round turn. Because it was important, right? To try and get back into the game. Drawing a Pernicious Deed during that part would have been so good, I think. It definitely would have been. Would have killed the Chalices, would have killed the Chrome Mox, would have killed all three of the tokens, or four, five, six of the tokens, I guess, if we'd actually done it in their turn. Meaning they'd only have two attackers, would block with both with Pyre and Toothy, would have a 15-15 Toothy. Oh, it would have been marvellous. It would have been marvellous. But it was not to be. I did think about playing three deeds in this deck. I do think that sometimes that is the right thing to do. But because we were low and or like zero, should I say, not low, on walkers, I prefer deed in the walker versions of the traditional mid-rangey, high mid-rangey Nykfit decks. I think we probably should have more 5 draws. There should be a Titania in this deck. Maybe Gitrog. Do you want to play first? Dryad Arbor? No, this is awful. This is better. It's not great. We don't have a black source for this Abrupt Decay. I'll probably put the Abrupt Decay back in the bin, honestly. Fetch a basic forest and just go from there. Keep. Decay is too good. Let's put Shifting Turtles back in the library. Let's lead with Catacombs into Forest. Bad times. Our hand just went from pretty good to just dreadful. So the vet doesn't do anything now. The Ramalot X vet doesn't do anything. Oh, for God's sake. Getting outplayed. I'm getting outplayed on turn one or turn zero every game. So their opening hand, no Simeon, no Petal. So, I mean, this is traditionally. The conventional logic is if you just go mountain passes, prison's not great, right? But they're doing that because they have Leon in the Void. Leon in the Void's very, very good here. Perhaps I should have got... No. I should have 100% got Bayou here so we could decay stuff. I can't decay this. And just die to Blood Moon because we have to play to our outs, which is... Okay. Yeah, we're going to get attacking because the vet dying right now is bad. We need a deed for 4. We need an Assassin's Trophy. I think Assassin's Trophy or a Rex Age. Just raw dog drawing the Rex Age would be sweet. Even if they moon us here, we'd still be able to play the Rex Age and block the Leon of the Void, and then we'd be unlocked, as it were. Pier, mountain. Pier under the chrome box, sorry, mountain. Make us to the moon. Sure thing. Sure thing. We untap and we draw a pernicious deed, which is locked away under the Blood Moon, plus the fact that we don't have a black source. Player Towers Tracker. No attacks. Once we draw a mountain, oh, we'll be in a good spot. I used to play a singular Birds of Paradise to Green Sun into. Don't do that anymore. Rabble. Okay, we can kill the 1-1 with a block of this turn. We really want to draw any land that is untapped. Well, all lands are untapped because all mountains. Preferably a basic swamp. We have 2 of them in the deck. We'll take a basic island. You know, just basics in general are good. Now, basic swamp would be real gas. It is not a basic swamp, nor a land. So we're just going to play a Collector Oof. Turns off the Chrome Mox. We can trade the Oof or the Tireless Tracker for the Rabble Master. If they attack with it, which they probably won't. Or maybe they will to kill the Oof to unlock the Chrome Mox to play a 3-drop if they don't have another mana source. That's reasonable. Stomp the Tracker. Seems pretty strong at this point. Rabble makes a 1-1. They do offer the trade. I am going to block. The more things we kill with the board. I mean, it unlocks their Chrome Mox. They can play a giant next turn, but I don't think we care too much. We drew a Green Suns. We're just going to Green Suns now. We're going to just cast it. We need something, right? We're going to get Scooze here. The land does, the Arbor doesn't do anything. Scooze allows us to eat the Rabble, and then yada, yada, yada. Well, I only allows us to eat things in their yard, importantly. And I need one thing at a turn because we only got one green source. Having a rough couple games. I will not lie to you. So they're going to play the giant this turn. If they have another rabble, they'll play the rabble first. They're never attacking with the Magus of the Moon. I guess there was an argument to hold on the Green Suns to draw a fourth land to get a Rex Age. But then we'll be being aggroed out pretty hard, I guess, is the problem. We draw a Pier, doesn't do anything. We're going to grow our Scooze in their turn, which will allow it to block 2/2s. It obviously can block 1/1s already. I won't trade it for the 4/3 just yet because it's too valuable. If they go for it, says a Legion War Boss. Okay, so having a blocker is very valuable here. Ramanap's actually not a terrible blocker either, honestly. Block here. Just going to eat their Rabble. Make ourselves a 3/3. kill that. Sure, take five. Ugh. Draw this singular copy of Brainstorm that we have. Okay. Play a Ramunap. I will trade the Ramunap and the Vet for the Giant at this point, I think. I think. Again, I can't really blame bad matchups. I don't feel like we should be this soft to mono red prison. I feel like we've got enough basics and vets and fetches. I mean, we are a little bit low on the fetch count. There is that. They have four cards in hand. We can't just take four over and over and over again, because we'll just die. We're at a point that even if we manage to claw our way out of this, like we did last game, we'll be at a stage where they can just overwhelm us with board presence. And we know they've got creatures that create like multiple bodies, not just singular one ones, but they're playing four Rabblemaster, probably four Warboss, and then maybe four Hanawar. So they're playing the 12 Rabble. There's a mountain, which doesn't do... Okay, yeah, we are... Game's over, I think. So they make a 1-1, they attack, they exile a 1-1, they get a different body from their deck with Fireflux Squad. Another 4-3. Yeah, I've seen enough. We've lost. Our next card was going to be a Cabal Therapy and then an Elder Gargoyle. So we were just completely boned. I'm not really sure what to say. Like, we got absolutely destroyed by Blood Moon, Charles on 1 and 2, and then Leon in the Void. Was that good? Their draws were good. Like, their draws didn't stumble at all. Ours were mediocre. But I think the hands I kept were the ones you had to kind of keep. Okay, I am filled with vigor. Let's do this. This is a one land. We're gonna mulligan this. We're gonna also mulligan this. Maybe the vigor was the incorrect thing to do. Maybe I shouldn't have been filled with even the smallest amount of vigor. What is this? Has our opponent kept seven? They have kept seven. Okay, we can mulligan. It's fine. I'd rather mulligan and have a good time. We need to put some cards back. We need to put two cards back. For the record, I don't want to keep this hand, but I feel like it's something we have to do. I'm going to put back a Phyrexian Tower, and we're going to put back an island. Oh, God. Keeping two lands and three. The Misty Rainforest. Let's pass the turn to our opponent. I wonder if they're going to Blood Moon or Chalice on one. Maybe they'll not do something turn one that's backbreaking. I mean, they can have Plowshares here. It doesn't break our back. Okay. I thought this was going to be a Chalice on one. Okay, if they wheel without locking us out of it, I would not be too upset. Is this Mono Blue Echoes or is this... I can't believe it. I literally cannot believe it. We are just going to scoop it up. We've multi five. We've got a Cabal Therapy. I'd rather hide what we're doing and surprise them, if I'm honest with you. Empty Turok. Abrupt Decay, Assassin's Trophy. I actually don't know if I like him here, actually. We're going to cut three Brainstorms and a Therapy. We're going to cut... We're going to cut Plague Engineer, maybe. Doesn't do a huge amount in this matchup. Clecktooth is obviously incredible. So is Scavenging Ooze. Yeah, let's cut the Plague Engineer. They might have Scythopter, Master Thopty, Thopty Thop, which would be then quite brutal if we don't have a Plague Engineer. So maybe we should keep access to one. Yeah, let's keep back. No, let's keep Knight in. Let's cut a tracker and keep access to one Plague Engineer. Just in case they have Psy. I mean, I've played bloody 5-mana Big Tezzeret in that deck before, so sometimes you just do make a lot of Thopters. Come on, dogs. Don't worry about it. That's my puppy and my dog. They just want out of here. They want out of the salt mines. We're going to play first. We're going to keep. This is actually pretty good. This is actually really good. We get to go Vet, Leyline of the Void, Diabolic Content of Vet away, go get a Collector Oof, and maybe that's just game. This hand is probably as good as it gets. You know, to quote Jack Nicholson in that famous, in Batman. Maybe this is as good as it gets. Now, we have to Fear Blood Moon here. We've got a Savannah, so we're going to get a Black-Green. We're going to get Bayou. Veteran Explorer. Pass to our opponent. They could have forcible with that, potentially. I guess this was one thing. Caracas. Okay. Caracas in the Echo Aeons deck. Mox Opal, Lotus Petal, Lion's Eye Diamond. Pass back to us. We get to make an oof and maybe they scoop. I'm saying that Legacy is back in this like good spot, but this will probably make you think it's not, right? Let's go Savannah because they still don't know that we are for the blue colored as well. I'm not even going to attack in case there's some like a Hull Breacher. They could Hull Breacher on Blot. Well, no. It's just better to say yes to this. They'll get an island out of this because they'll play at least one island, right? We've got an island in hand, so we're going to get a black and a green. Diabolic Intent being a Demonic Tutor, which will go grab us a Collector Oof here. Got two islands. Okay, yeah, fair enough. One time I force a will. Got a flash and a Hull Breacher while I'm doing this. Yeah, sure. Okay. Toth and Mox over Lotus Petal and Lion's Eye Diamond. They have no graveyard either. They have access to 4 mana this turn. They could just cast an Urza. Then we've got to deal with an Urza. There's a Bauble. They attack us with a 3-2. Say okay. Okay, we're going to untap. And we're going to play a Knight of the Reliquary. I'm not going to attack in case of a second Hull Breacher. I don't want to lose the Collector Oof because it unlocks too much of their stuff. I'm just going to play super carefully around, well, Collector Hull Breachers basically. I'm going to attack again. No, they don't want to trade with my knight. I wouldn't trade with the knight anyway, I don't think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we're not on Field of the Dead mana just yet. I will go ahead and Reclamation Sage their Seat of the Synod, perhaps. Actually, Lion's Eye Diamond is the worst one if they kill our Collector Oof. pass to our opponent. Okay. End of turn, let's go and crack this forest for a Field of the Dead. There we go, we untap, we draw Bojuga, we play an island, make a 2-2. Go to combat attack with a 2-1. They go to 18. They play an ancient tomb. They can almost wheel us, but I don't think we wouldn't really care. They get a lot of treasure they can't use. They draw 7, which would be strong. They can wheel us next turn. I probably have to get a wasteland next turn, block that ancient tomb, I think. Just to be on the safe side. I think him. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 mana. Plus, I guess they could be on some wild Simian Spirit Guide or Elvish Spirit Guide variant. On the whole, people don't play that, though. That's not a thing. 4 mana for Khan. Okay. I can go get a bridge. What do they grab? Are they ticked up and they play an Emery? Okay. Cool. End of turn, I'm going to sack this Savannah. I'm going to grab a fetch land here and make a lot of zombies. Make sure I can fetch stuff still. I can. We're going to get Misty. Make a Zombo. I want to crack the Misty. Grab a Trop. Make a Zombo. Untap. Draw a Plague Engineer, which is something. Make a Zombo. We're then going to activate Knight, sacking the Bayou. Bobby, it's alright, mate. It's my puppy still wants out. Grab a wasteland. Make a zombie. We're then going to blow up the ancient tomb to keep them off of the microsynth. It's alright, buddy. It's okay. My puppy really wants... Come here. Come on, buddy. Come say hello to channelfireball.com. If you want to see pictures of my puppy, you can follow me on Instagram. It's alright, baby dog. Okay. Then I guess we just play a Plague Engineer. We're going to name just Merfolk, I guess, because, yeah. We go to combat, and we attack. Everything at Khan barring the Collector Oof. Then we just kill them next turn. This way Khan can't, like, lattice lock us somehow? So Khan goes to 2. He can still go get an ensnaring bridge, and that's the real problem. And then I've got to draw a Pernicious Deed, which will rack our board, or I guess Assassin's Trophy or Abrupt Decay. See, at the center they can't use, they're under 3 mana, they can go get a bridge. Play it for 3. Unless I've got a 0 mana card in hand, all my 2-2s can still attack. Yeah, they get the bridge. Of course they do. Now my other dog wants the other dog that's on my lap. Go on, boys. Good play. Good play. Wait, bridge comes down. We'll get to attack with a lot of 2-2s for 1 turn. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 we'll get to hit them with. We drew Imaginative Rascal, so we're going to go ahead and play Imaginative Rascal. Then we'll grab a Toothy from our deck. We're going to play Toothy. We're going to hit them for 14. Then they're going to stabilize, it looks like. Get a Pier in our hand, I guess. It gets out of the deck. In for a bunch. In for a penny, in for a pound, as they say. They go to 2. Okay. If they can play a land plus play a card from their hand, they'll be good. It might be that their hand is just full of like Echo of Aeons and stuff they can't cast. Land. Okay. And a Hole Breacher. Cool. That stops us from attacking. We're going to sack this Trop. We actually have green mana if I'm not careful here. We're going to grab a Horizon Canopy. Actually, no, we're going to grab a Verdant. Make a Zombo. The Verdant's then going to crack and grab a Forest. And then we can sack that Forest to go and get ourselves a Horizon Canopy if we want to draw a card. Toothy's going to get 2 counters. We drew a Swamp, which is not ideal. We're going to sack the Forest. Grab a Horizon Canopy. Or are we going to Wasteland them so they can't Echo? We can't actually crack this Canopy. If we crack this Canopy, we have no green sources left in our deck. That turns off all our outs as well. So I guess I've got to get a Wasteland and Wasteland their Tomb and try and get cards stuck in their hand. That's our game plan. I should have played the Pier before I did that. Can attack with only Pier here, which I 100% should. Because I can... should I? No. We'll wait until we've got that and a Dryad. Oh, maybe I should have got a Dryad. No, Wasteland's hopefully trans cards in their hand. Hopefully trans cards in their hand. They play another land. Oh,
stop it, Bobby. Come up here then, mate.
Just wants my attention. Everyone wants my attention. I'm rather popular among both dogs and YouTube commenters. I am a dog scientist. That is my jam. We drew a Phyrexian Tower. So we only have 2 more green sources left in our deck. We can attack with a Pier, which we will. Will they block? They really want to breach us, don't they? But no blocks. They get a 1. We have 32 cards left in our library. Only 2 of them are green sources. That's because my mana base is incredibly greedy. They have another Hole Breacher. 4 mana. This is going to be an Urza, isn't it? A chance on 2. Okay, Abrupt Decay being our only out to the bridge now. That or stopping them from casting spells. Shifting Celtops don't do nothing. We attack with Pia here. Yeah, I should have got a Dryad Arbor. Maybe Wasteland them's correct, though. If they went Tundra and then like drew 7. Hope Witcher is dead. I want to draw a second Echoes here or something. Something they cannot cast. They counter their own chalice for chalice, and my puppy is just whining at me. It's all right, Bobwell. It's okay. Oh, no. Now he's barking at me. That's fine. I'm going to put him back on my lap, and then he'll want down again. Then he'll bark at me again. We're going to untap. We're going to draw an excavator. We're going to just pass the turn back to our opponent. Maybe this Legacy League, maybe this recording wasn't for me today. Maybe I should not have dared to record in my work day because my dogs don't want me to. The game scenarios don't want me to. We have one out in our deck for Ensnaring Bridge if they keep casting spells. And this is my own fault for going so ham on those green sources and only realizing quite late. That's a Khan. So they're now going to lock me out of the game. Oh, very careful. Just jumping off my lap again. So they just tick down and get Magnificent Flash. That's all they need to do. And then we're dead. Yep. Get the lattice. Maybe we'll get stuck in... Hang on. They got LED. Because they realise if they got lattice there, we've been stuck in their hand. Pass back to them. If only we could have play engineered our own Zombos to make them 1-1s, that would have been sweet. Whatever. No, we don't have any 1-1s in our deck we can play. They did something. They ticked up on something. I don't know what it was. Draw another ley line. Just want to draw. We've got to draw Horizon Canopy into Abrupt Decay. The chances are so low. So we're just sat here hoping they just don't cast the spells they draw. Bounce the collector roof. Yeah, bounce the collector roof. Cast Echo? No, because that'll undo the Ensnaring Bridge. So maybe they can't do that, actually. Also, down-ticking Teferi puts a card into their hand. But that said, if they bounce the collector roof, they'll be able to cast whatever they draw, right? Like, they have so much mana. Likelihood of it being a 0 CMC artifact is very high. Okay, my puppy is finally making his bed behind me now. That's nice. What do they do now? Do they just lattice lock me or something, perhaps? 6 mana, make a lattice. So we are lattice locked. They have 2 cards in hand. That's my wife taking the dogs away. That's good. We're on 1 life. They got 2 cards in hand. They need to somehow empty a card from their hand. Do we get them here? They cast the chance that was in their hand. Okay. Game's over then, kids. Game's over. Can't attack them. That's it. It was a terrible league. Not going to lie to you. Some ways I don't even want to upload this, but I'll be honest, I'm too busy to send off another one. I got to do another league for something else now. So that's nice. Sometimes you try and sign up for a Magic event and it just goes badly. Think of those GP side events, right? One of your friends has signed up to a side event and somehow they've been locked in a room with a puppy dog that wouldn't shut up and now it's barking outside in the corridor. I mean, it's adorable. I love Buffalo, but he was quite distracting. And also your friend who signed up for that event, who's now moaning that they've gone 0-3 drop, their deck was garbage, and you didn't have the heart to tell them. But to be fair, the comment section will tell me. So I look forward to it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all soon. Don't forget to smash that like button. That was an embarrassingly bad Legacy League. Fun times.